Dear students, as you know, your UT1 will be in the month of August, that is this month. So today we will revise the first chapter of English literature, that is three questions. In your exam, the questions in English literature will be in the form of choose the correct options, answer in one word and complete the statements. In MCQs or choose the correct option, you know very well that there will be a question with four options. Among them, one will be correct and you have to choose the correct option. In answer in one word, you have to answer the question in one word. But be careful, your spelling should be correct. For correct spelling, you will get 1 mark and for incorrect spelling, you will get 0. So be very, very particular about spellings of the words. Then complete the statement. One statement will be given. Then you have to fill in the blank or space with the appropriate word. So let us start chapter 1, three questions. In this chapter, we have to discuss about these things. The title of the story, three questions. This story is about three questions that to which the king wanted to know the answers. Second is, who is the writer of this story? Leo Tolstoy. Leo Tolstoy is the author of this story. Then you should know all the characters or main characters of this story. First is king. Second is hermit and the third is the wounded man or the bedded man. Now about the king. Once a certain king gets a thought that he would never fail if he knew three things. If he knew answers to these three questions. What were the questions? What was the right time to begin everything? Who were the right people to listen to and whom to avoid? And what was the most important thing to do? Then the second character is the hermit. When the king didn't get proper answers to his questions, he decided to go to a hermit. The hermit lived in the wood and would only see common people. However, the king put on simple dress, left his guards behind and went to see the hermit. When the king approached, the hermit was digging the ground in front of his hut. The king asked his question. The third character is the wounded man. The king asked three questions to hermit. Before the hermit could answer, a man emerged from the woods. He was bleeding from a terrible stomach wound. So the king and the hermit washed the wound and bandaged till the blood ceased. So in this way, the king and the hermit nursed the wounded man. So you should know that what the story is about. Then the writer of the story, that is Leo Tolstoy, and the main characters of the story. Now we will see word meaning. You have to learn all the word meanings. Word meaning can come in the form of choose the correct option or fill in the blank. One word will be given and there will be four options. One will be correct and three will be wrong. You have to put tick mark to the correct answer. It also can come in the form of fill in the blank. Now we will talk about question answers. You have to learn all the question answers thoroughly because one word answer type questions will be framed from the middle of those answers that you have to learn thoroughly. Then we will talk about exercises of this chapter. There are exercises on page number 15. You have already done. Left hand side words are there and right hand side meanings are there. You have to learn these meaning of these words. There will be no matching. Then exercise 2 is there. In this exercise, you have to fill in the blanks with two words. One word will be given and you have to use that word in two forms. For example, the dash said that only fresh evidence would make him change his dash. The word is judge. You have to, in first blank you have to write judge and in second blank you have to write judgment. So the answer will be the judge said that only fresh evidence would make him change his judgment. Now complete the statements from your practice book, that is worksheet 1. Here the statement is given and then one word is left, that is that you have to fill with appropriate word. And complete the statement can also come from middle of the chapter. So you should go through the chapter properly. Now the second one is poem The Squirrel. Of course you have to learn the poet of this poem, that is Mildred Bowers Armstrong. And then question answers, and after that complete the statement from work practice book. You can see here page number 8, worksheet 2. The first question is the squirrel had a dash for his tail. So in blank you have to write question mark. And I told you be careful about the spellings. Then number 2, he sat up straight for eating a dash, that is nut. Number 3, the squirrel loves to dash. The answer is tease and play. In this way you have to complete these statements. So read the chapter properly.